I'll just share my screen. Can you see the screen, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, yesterday we were solving Fredholm integral equation when the kernel was resolvent, was separable. Okay, so we have done how to solve Fredholm integral equation when the kernel was separable. Right now, today we will be discussing something called method of successive substitutions. Okay, this is also called iterative method, and this is also called this method solution using Norman series. Okay, here this method is both for Fredholm as well as for Volterra, and also there is no condition that your kernel is separable. Is that okay? So let me tell you what this method is. So before starting this method, we should know what is called iterative kernels. So there is a definition, iterative kernels, right? So what I am going to do is, on one side I will write Fredholm integral equation, and on the other side I'll write for Volterra, so that everything is clear to you. So let us do like this. So here I'm doing everything for Fredholm, here I'm writing everything for Volterra. Fine. So can you
ऊपर scroll करना एक बार?
Yes, beta. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So everybody knows, right, what is Fredholm, what is Volterra. So I'm just, for the sake of completeness, I'm writing here f of x is equal to f of x, y of x is equal to f of x plus lambda a to b k x t y t dt. This is your Fredholm, and here I'm writing y of x is equal to f of x plus lambda a to x k x t y t dt. This is your Volterra, right? So the first thing we are going to define is iterative kernel. Iterative kernels. So what are iterative kernels? So we define kxt simply as whatever this k is. Okay, then we define k2xt as a to b kxt k1zt dz. This is the definition. Then we define k3xt as a to b kxz k2zt dz. Then we define k4xt is equal to a to b kxz k3zt dz, and so on. And we define kmxt as a to b kxz km minus 1 zt dz. Clear to everybody? So this is the formula for iterative kernels. These are called k1, k2, k3, k4, and so on. You can keep on computing these functions. These are called iterative kernels. Clear, Vida? This is just a definition. And in case of Volterra, iterative kernels are, you have again k1xt. Now your limits of integration are here from a to x. So k1xt is simply kxt, and k2xt is integration from t to x kxz k1zt dz. Then k3xt is integration from t to x kxz k2zt dz, and so on. So general formula is kmxt is t2x kxz km-1zt dz. So this is the definition of iterative kernel for Fredholm and Volterra. You just have to note that in case of Fredholm, you have to take the limits a to b. In case of Volterra, you don't have to take limits from a to b. Instead, you have to take limits from t to x. Why? Because we are not going to prove, but in solution we will be using these iterative kernels for solving these equations. So there we need it from t to x. Any doubt in the definition of iterative kernels? Okay, so yesterday I told you what is the resolvent kernel. Can you tell me the definition? Anybody? Yesterday I told you the definition of resolvent kernel. Can you tell me? Yes? No? Okay. If the solution of, say your equation is Fredholm, y of x is equal to f of x plus lambda, a to b kxt yt dt. Here, this is the unknown function. Suppose the solution of this equation takes the form y of x is equal to f of x plus lambda a to b. Here, in place of kxt, you have rxt lambda, some function. And in place of yt, you have ft dt. If this happens, then rxt t lambda is called the resolvent kernel. Okay, yesterday we have seen, we have also found the resolvent kernel for some equations. And here also the definition is similar. Right? Now, I will give you a direct formula for computing the resolvent kernel. So, we have formula for computing the resolvent kernel using the iterative kernels. Computing the resolvent kernel. So the formula is that rxt lambda is equal to summation m from 1 to infinity lambda raised to power m minus 1 kmxt. So what is this? This is a series. So you have k1xt plus lambda k2 plus lambda square k3 plus lambda 4 k lambda cube k4 plus lambda 4 k5 and so on. So you have this infinite series, and if it is convergent, then the sum is equal to the resolvent kernel. Is that okay? So I just told you that how to compute the iterative kernels, and then I told you this definition of resolvent kernel which we had discussed yesterday also. And then you have this formula for resolvent kernel. Okay. And once you find the resolvent kernel, you see, once you find the resolvent kernel, your solution is here. Okay. So if you put similar is here, this formula is same here for Volterra also. So if you put this value of resolvent kernel in the solution, you'll get y of x is f of x plus lambda a to b resolvent kernel is this summation m from 1 to infinity lambda raised to power m minus 1 km. This is your resolvent kernel. Y ki jagah pe you will get ft dt. Is that thing clear? So your solution is f of x is equal to summation f of x plus summation m from 1 to infinity lambda raised to power m a to b kmxt ft dt. Okay. And this series is called Norman series. The solution is called Norman series solution. Is that thing clear, beta? So yeah, here also yeah. You have y of x is equal to f of x plus summation m from 1 to infinity lambda raised to power m a to b kmxt ft dt. So this is the Norman series solution. फाइव. दिस इज बोथ फॉर वोल्टेरा एंड फॉर फ्रेडहोम. लेट अस डू द प्रॉब्लम्स नाउ. क्वेश्चंस करते हैं, देन यू विल गेट एवरीथिंग मोर क्लियरली. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सॉल्व y of x इज इक्वल टू x प्लस 0 टू हाफ y t dt यूजिंग डिसॉल्वेंट कर्नल. ओके, क्लियर है क्वेश्चन सबको? दैट दिस इज अ फ्रेडहोम इक्वेशन. यू हैव टू फाइंड द रिजॉल्वेंट कर्नल एंड वंस यू फाइंड द रिजॉल्वेंट कर्नल यू कैन वेरी इजीली फाइंड द सॉल्यूशन. सो लेट अस ट्राई टू फाइंड रिजॉल्वेंट कर्नल. सो यू हैव फॉर्मूला फॉर रिजॉल्वेंट कर्नल इज इक्वल टू समेशन एम फ्रॉम 1 टू इंफिनिटी lambda raised to power m minus 1 km x t. So it means that you have to compute kms. Now can you tell me what is k here? Can you tell me what is k x t here? What is lambda here? What is f of x? Tell me beta. K x t is whatever is here. What is with y t is 1. What is lambda? Whatever is outside is also 1. What is f of x? This is your f of x.
X. What?
Yes. F of x is x. So let us find out k1. K1 x t is same as k x t. So that is 1. What is k2 x t? That will be integration limits from 0 to half k x z k1 z t dz. So k is 1. K1 is also 1. Dz 0 to half. So this is z 0 to half. So that is half. So k2 is your half. K3 is k3 xt will be 0 to half kxz k2 zt dz. So this is equal to 0 to half. This is 1. Kxz is 1. K2 zt is half dz. So this is 1 by 2 z 0 to half. So this is 1 by 2 square. Now can you guess what will be K4? That will be 1 by 2 cube.
1 by 2 cube.
Right? So in general, your KMXT is 1 by 2 raised to power M minus 1. Because for 4, you have power 3. For 3, you have power 2 and so on. Fine? So what is your resolvent kernel? Therefore, resolvent kernel is equal to M from 1 to infinity. Lambda raised to power M minus 1. Km, which is equal to m from 1 to infinity, lambda raised to power m minus 1, half raised to power m minus 1. Fine? Can you tell me what is this? And lambda in this case is 1, right? Lambda here is 1, you see? So lambda is 1. So this is equal to m from 1 to infinity, 1 by 2. So what is this series?
GP series.
GP series, ma'am.
Convergent. Is it convergent,
yes,
or
ma'am,
divergent?
Common ratio 1 by 2.
Because common ratio is half, which is less than 1. So the sum is A upon 1 minus R. So sum is 2. So your resolvent kernel is equal to 2. So therefore, solution is, tell me, y of x is equal to f of x plus lambda 0 to half kx ki jagah pe kya jayega? R x t lambda. Aur y t ki jagah pe kya jayega? F of t dt. So this is f of x, yahan pe x hai, lambda 1 hai, 0 to half, resolvent kernel abhi aapne 2 compute kiya, into ft is t, because f of x is x, dt, right? So this is x plus t square, 0 to half. So this is x plus 1 by 4. So y is equal to x plus 1 by 4 is your solution. Is that thing clear? Samajh mein aaya sabko? ओके, सो लेट अस डू वन मोर प्रॉब्लम, बिकॉज़ यहां पे बहुत सिंपल थी कैलकुलेशंस, आपका हाफ आ रहा था, ठीक है? सो लेट अस डू वन मोर प्रॉब्लम. सो यू हैव सॉल्व y of x इज इक्वल टू 1 प्लस लैम्डा 0 टू 1 1 माइनस 3xt yt dt, राइट, यूजिंग डिसॉल्वेंट कर्नल. सो कैन यू सी हियर, when lambda is not given, like anything is not given, then obviously when you solve you will get some conditions on lambda, that for this value the solution exists and for this value solution does not exist, as we have already seen, right? So here you can see what is your f of x is 1 and what is your kxt, that is 1 minus 3xt. Fine. So let us compute the iterative kernels, right? So you have your resolvent kernel as, resolvent kernel is summation m from 1 to infinity lambda raised to power m minus 1 km xt, right? So we will just compute the iterative kernels, and that will, from those iterative kernels, we'll find the resolvent kernel. And once we have the resolvent kernel, we very easily can compute the solution. So here, let us compute the iterative kernels. So k1xt is simply kxt, which is 1 minus 3xt. And then you have k2xt, that will be 0 to 1 kxz k1zt dz. So that is equal to 0 to 1 kxz is 1 minus 3xz k1zt is, again the same. Can you tell me what it will be? K1zt?
1 minus 3zt.
Okay. So you will replace x with z and t is as such. Okay. Dz. Now you have to integrate carefully with respect to z. So I'm just writing what you will get. You integrate, you will get 1 minus 3 by 2 x plus t plus 3xt. Fine. And then you can compute k3xt. That will be 0 to 1. Kxz k2zt dz. So you just, this is 0 to 1. Kxz is 1 minus 3xz k2zt. Yahan pe aayega 1 minus 3 by 2z plus t plus 3zt. With respect to z, you have to integrate. So I'm just telling what you will get. This is equal to 1 by 2, 1 minus 3xt. Can you see this is equal to 4. 1 by 4, this is K1. Okay. So next, K4, when you will compute, calculation is a little difficult, but this will be 1 by 4 times K2. When you will compute K5, that is 1 by 4 square times K1. When you compute K6, that will be 1 by 4 square times K2, and so on. Okay. So your resolvent kernel will be, क्या है आपका, m from 1 to infinity lambda raised to power m minus 1 km. So this is k1 plus lambda k2 plus lambda square k3 plus lambda cube k4 plus lambda 4 k5 plus lambda 6 sorry lambda 5 k6 and so on. Now these, they are all multiples of k1, so you can combine them. So this is k1 plus lambda square. K3 is 1 by 4 times K1. So this is lambda square upon 4 K1. And this will be lambda ki power 4 upon 4 square into K1 and so on. And you combine all these. This will give you lambda common, or you can just write lambda. K2 is as such. This will be lambda square by 4 K2. Plus, then next term is lambda 4 by 4 square, K2 and so on, right? So, this is equal to K1 plus lambda K2 into, you have a series, 1 by lambda square by 4 plus lambda raised to power 4 upon 4 square and so on, right? So, this is the GP with common ratio. Kitna hai? Lambda square by 4, okay? So it is convergent for lambda square by 4 less than 1. So you have to put this condition. In that case, your resolvent kernel is k1 plus lambda k2 into a upon 1 minus r. So that is equal to, now you can just put the value of k1 and k2. K1 is here, k2 is here. So I'm just writing, you'll get your resolvent kernel as, your resolvent kernel will be 4 upon 4 minus lambda square, 1 minus 3xt plus lambda, 1 minus 3 by 2x plus t plus 3xt, with the condition that lambda square should be less than 4. Clear, beta? You clear hai sabko? So, my I just want to tell you that calculations are not so simple. If you are computing the resolvent kernel using this series, the calculations are not very simple. So you can use the method which we have done yesterday also. So almost same computation is there. Is that okay, beta? Kisi ko doubt nahi hai tab? Now once you have computed your resolvent kernel, you can compute your solution as y of x is equal to f of x plus lambda resolvent kernel ft dt, and your integration was 0 to 1. So if you do this, you'll get this solution. 4 plus 2 lambda 2 minus 3x upon 4 minus lambda square. So this is your solution. Is that okay? Just put the value here. Ft is your, kya diya hua isme? Ft is 1, right? And then you have to integrate. So this is the final solution you'll get. Fine? So to avoid all these calculations, sometimes we just approximate the solutions. We find the approximate solutions instead of the exact solution. And that method is called method of successive approximations. Method of successive approximations. So what is that method? That you have this equation y of x is equal to y of x is equal to f of x plus lambda a to b k x t y t dt. So do you remember Picard's method for solving differential equations? Yes. Do you remember Picard's method, beta? Yaad hai kisi ko?
Yes, ma'am.
उसमें क्या करते हो आप एक सॉल्यूशन एज्यूम कर लेते हो वाई नॉट एंड देन यूजिंग दैट वाई नॉट यू कंप्यूट वाई वन व्हिच इज अ बेटर सॉल्यूशन एंड देन यू कंप्यूट वाई टू व्हिच इज स्टिल बेटर एंड सो ऑन सो हियर आल्सो व्हाट वी डू वी स्टार्ट विद एन इनिशियल अप्रोक्सीमेशन वी कॉल इट एज वाई नॉट दिस इज योर इनिशियल अप्रोक्सीमेशन ओके एंड इफ इट इज नॉट गिवन वी जनरली टेक इट इज इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ एक्स ओके और इट इज given in the question. Fine? And then using y naught, you compute y1x as f of x plus lambda a to b. Here you'll put y naught. Kxt y naught t dt. This is called first order approximation. First order approximate solution. So this is not the exact solution of the integral equation, but an approximate solution. And then you compute y2xt, that will be f of x plus lambda a to b kxt y1t dt. So this is called second order approximate solution. Fine? And then you compute y3x, that will be f of x plus lambda a to b kxt y2t dt, which is called third order approximate solution, and so on. So you can keep on doing this thing. Fine, you can keep on computing. In general, you have ymx, which is the mth order approximate solution, is equal to f of x plus lambda a to b kxt ym minus 1t dt. Clear beta sabko? So we can actually prove that under some conditions on K and F, this sequence which we are computing, sequence of functions, will converge to the exact solution. Okay, so let us do one problem. You have solve y of x is equal to 1 plus lambda 0 to 1 x plus t yt dt by the method of successive approximations, by the method of successive approximations up to third order. Up to third order means you have to compute till y3. So you'll start with y naught will be equal to f of x. Can you tell me what is f of x here? That is one.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, this method can be applied in both kind of equations.
Yes. Okay. Everything which I'm saying is for both the equations, Volterra as well as for Fredholm. I'm just taking the example of Fredholm. After that, we'll be doing Volterra examples also. Okay, beta.
And there will be change in limits, hai na? Aur sara same rahega.
Everything is same. You just have to remember. I told you here in iterative kernel, the limits will be T2x for iterative kernel. Ma'am. Everything else, everywhere else, the limit will be from A to X. Okay, for Volterra.
Okay,
Volterra limits will be from A to X, na? So you A to X rakhoge. But if you are computing the iterative kernels, then it is from T2x. Fine.
Okay, ma'am.
I'll do the problems. Iske baad Volterra wali. So your Y naught is f of x, which is 1. Then your y1x will be 1 plus lambda 0 to 1 x plus t y naught t dt. So this is equal to 1 plus lambda 0 to 1 x plus t y naught t is 1 dt. So this is 1 plus lambda x plus half. Fine. So this is your first order approximate solution. This is your zeroth order approximate solution. Then you have y2x. That will be 1 plus lambda 0 to 1 x plus t y1 t dt. So that will be 1 plus lambda 0 to 1 x plus t y1 t is 1 plus lambda t plus half dt. Okay, so this is equal to 1 plus lambda x plus half plus lambda square x plus 7 by 12. So this is your second order approximate solution. Okay, and similarly you can compute the third order also. So third order approximate solution will be 1 plus lambda 0 to 1 x plus t y to t dt. So you can do the computation. This is what you will get. 1 plus lambda x plus half plus lambda square x plus 7 by 12 plus lambda cube 13 by 12 x plus 5 by 8. So these are the approximate solutions, not the exact one. Clear hai sabko? Kisi ko doubt beta? Now I'll do two examples for Volterra. Question is, solve y of x is equal to e raised power x square plus 0 to x e raised power x square minus t square y t dt using resolvent kernel. So it means that we have to first find the resolvent kernel. So you have r x t lambda is your summation m from 1 to infinity lambda raised to power m minus 1 k m x t. Fine. So here let us compute the iterative kernels. So k1 x t will be same as k x t, which is e raised to power x square minus t square. So what will be k2xt? Tell me, beta. Limits will be from t2x kxz k1zt dz. So this is t2x kxz will be e raised power x square minus z square. k1zt will be e raised power z square minus t square dz. So this is equal to t2x e raised power x square minus z square, minus t square, z square will cancel, dz. Now there is no z here, so you can take it out. So it is e raised power x square minus z square. Integration of z, 1 will be z from t to x. So this is e raised power x square minus, t square. T square into x minus t. So this is your k2. Got it, beta? Now let us compute K3. You have to compute 3, 4 so that you get a pattern. So that will be T2X, KXZ, K2ZT, DZ. So that is equal to T2X, e raised power X square minus Z square. Put here, in place of X, you replace X with Z. This is e raised power Z square minus T square, Z minus T, DZ. So again, you will get e raised power.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am, you're not audible.
Karan, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, बेटा बीच में चला गया था ना connection. Okay. So can you tell me कहाँ तक आपने ये समझ में आ गया? That resolvent kernel is this series.
And screen this is series not visible, ma'am.
Not visible. Okay. Screen is not visible. Now is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so ये हो गया था हमने we have computed the iterated kernels and then you just put the form put in the formula for resolvent kernel so you will get e raised power x square minus c square and this series here the series is for exponential which is convergent always clear so this is your resolvent kernel therefore your solution is y of x is equal to f of x which is e raised power x square y of x is equal to e raised power x square plus 1, 0 to x. This is your resolvent kernel, x square minus t square, e raised power x minus t. यहाँ पे क्या आएगा? F of t, which is e raised power t square dt. So यहाँ पे आपका आ जाएगा. इसको compute कर लीजिए. You'll get e raised power x square plus x. So this is your solution. Got it? Yes. कर लो बेटा सारे questions ऐसे हैं. I'm giving you one problem. Write the Norman series for y of x is equal to 1 plus x plus lambda 0 to x, x minus t, y t, dt. Okay, so the answer is 1 plus x plus lambda x squared by 2 factorial, x cubed by 3 factorial, plus lambda square, x is power 4 by 4 factorial, x is power 5 by 5 factorial, and so on. So this is your answer. Okay? So, we are left with one topic, that is conversion of differential equations into integral equations. Fine, tomorrow we will be doing that, and day after tomorrow we will be doing some problems like for tutorial class. Then we are finished with our syllabus. ओके बेटा,
ओके मैम,
ओके. So, if you have any doubts, we still have 2-3 minutes. You can ask me. कोई doubt हो बेटा, please ask your doubts. नहीं है किसी को? So please practice these questions. मैं आपको questions भेजूंगी भी. ठीक है? Okay then. Thank you everybody. Have a nice day. और आपने कोई इसका सोचा कब दोगे?